So far in this series of DBMS lectures, we have discussed all the normal forms and decomposition and two decomposition properties, dependency preserving and lossless joint decomposition. In the previous video, we have discussed some practice questions, means decomposition is given and how to check that the particular decomposition is lossless joint or not. There in that video, we have discussed simple questions, means we have taken a relation and we have decomposed the relation into two sub-relation only. Right. In this video, I'll discuss a little bit complex example. Here, I have decomposed the relation into three sub-relations, and now you need to check this decomposition is lossless joint decomposition or not. Right. This is another form of representing the decomposition. See, D for decomposition, and here I have, see, one R1 relation containing attribute ABC. This one is for R2, CDE, and this is R3EF. So three sub-relations are there, right? Right, and data is not given, functional dependencies are given on this relation. Now check that this decomposition is lossless join or not. See, it's not like that we can do R1 natural join, R2 natural join, R3 at one time, because natural join is binary operator. You can join only two relations, two sub-relations, you can say, right? We cannot join all the three at one time. Two means, now the question is which pair you will take, either this one or which one. You can take any pair, it's up to you. R1, R2 at first, or R2, R3 at first, or R1, R3 at first. Right? See how to do this thing. Now, we know we have to check three properties basically, right? To check that this decomposition is lossless or not. First is what? The union of attribute of all the decomposed sub-relations must be equal to the attribute of the relation. Just do the union A, B, C, D, E and F. Are you getting all the attribute of the relation? Yes. Okay, fine. Next one. Now, take two sub-relations. Suppose here you are taking R1 and R3. Right? I want to do R1 natural join R3 first of all. Right? Now, first of all, check. Is R1 and R3 have any common attribute? Because for natural join, definitely you need one common attribute, right? Here ABC, here EF. No, we don't have any common attribute. And what I have said in previous video, that if no common attribute, then that would be lossy. No, that is not lossless. But here directly, you cannot say that this is lossy decomposition, right? Okay, fine. Here we don't have any common attribute, but we still have two more pair left. Now you can take R1, R2. Or you can take R2, R3. Now also you can check, right? Suppose I am checking for R1 and R2. Now I am taking this pair, R1, R2 first of all. Is there any common attribute? Yes, I have common attribute, that is C. Means R1 intersection R2 is C. So third is what? The C must be the candidate key of at least one sub-relation, either this one or this one. Because I am performing natural join on these two. So the C must be candidate key for either this one or maybe for both. Now how to check that C is candidate key or not? Means you can say C is candidate key of a relation if C can derive all the attribute of that relation, right? So for C to be candidate key for R1, C must derive both A and B. For C to be candidate key of R2, C must drive D and E, right? Now, how to check this type of functional dependency exists or not? Simple trick is just find out C closer, right? Fine, this is the method. Now, how to find out C closer using the given functional dependency set? C closer will definitely contain C. Now, using C, I can drive D. I have C, I can drive D. Using D, I can drive EF. So I have D, I can drive EF. Using F, I can drive A. Okay, fine. Using D, I can drive B. I have D, I can drive B. Right? Okay, that's it. Now, check. If C closer contains both AB, it means C is driving both AB. Right? Yes, A and B. C is able to drive both A and B. So now you can say that C is candidate key for R1. No need to check for R2. If you want to check, then you can check. C can drive both TE. Yes. using C I can try both DE. So C is candidate key for R2 as well here, fortunately. So here C is candidate key for both R1 and R2, or you can say C is super key for both R1 and R2. Now you can say this is what R1, R2 join is what lossless join decomposition, right? But still we are not over, right? So here I am writing this. If you do R1 natural join R2, suppose I am denoting it with R12 relation, and it will contain attribute A, B, C, D, E. Now we are left with R3. Now we will do natural join of this one and this one finally, right? Now check, is there any common attribute between these two? Yes, E is common attribute. So now check, E is candidate key for this one or this one, either relation, right? How to check? Just find out E closure. How to find out E closure? Using functional dependency set. Using E, I can drive E itself, obviously. Now, using E, I cannot drive anything. So E closure contains E only, and this is trivial. So if you don't write, that also fine, right? Because by default, E can drive itself. Now, check. Can E drive all the attribute of this relation? No, because E closure contain only E. Can E drive all the attribute of this relation? Can E drive F? No, E can drive only E. So now E is neither candidate key for this one nor for this one. So this composition is what? Not lossless. So finally, you can say that this decomposition is what? Lossy decomposition, right? It is not lossless join decomposition. Fine. Now, if you update like this, suppose I am adding now one more dependency, that is. Now, where you will find the change? See, simply suppose first I am taking R1 and R2, find out C closure, because common is C, it is containing obviously all the attribute of this one and this one also, so it is candidate key. So this is what? Lossless. First, this natural join, this decomposition is what? Lossless. Now, combine with this R3, now C. Common attribute is E. If you find out now C closure, then you can get E, and E can drive F, right? And also F can drive A, right? Nothing else. Now see, E is candidate key for this one? No, because E closure is not containing all the attribute of this relation. But E closure contains F, means here this functional dependency exists, means E can drive F. Means E can drive all attribute of this subrelation. So now you can say, see, E can drive F. So E is candidate key for R3. And that's exactly we want. E should be candidate key for at least one subrelation. So now this is what, suppose I am, finally when you will do, when you will join, you will get A, B, C, D, E and F, right? And if E is candidate key of at least one subrelation, then definitely this decomposition is now lossless join decomposition, right? So I hope now you got, if this type of decomposition is given, means three subrelations are given, then how to check. So now the question for you is, you need to check this decomposition is dependency preserving or not. This is the relation, these are the functional dependencies, you need to consider E to F also, and thus the decomposition, and now you need to check this is dependency preserving or not. This is lossless join decomposition after including this functional dependency. If you don't write this functional dependency, then it is not lossless, right? So now this is all about decomposition, right? From the next video, we will discuss how to convert a relation into higher normal form. Suppose a relation is given into first NF, then how to convert it into second, third and BCNF, right? With three or four examples, and after that we will discuss fourth normal form and fifth normal form, as well as a multi-valued functional dependency, right? So now I'll see in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.